Hello, this is Lemsko again. This time I want to show you a sortie I flew with Oz, Silencer and Salty together. We were choosing P-47s, snow map, hard spotting, and add a thick cloud layer. So not optimal environment for the P-47. But we can show you that despite the clouds and the low eye dogfights, if you're in a group, it's a fantastic airplane. The P-47 keeps you alive and good control over the whole speed area, especially in very, very high speed. You see, we are climbing a little bit to the west. Battlefield stays on our 2 o'clock position. This is my plane. Oz has a red tail and a shark mouth. And Silencer is flying without any decals. And on Salty's plane, you see the horse and the Polish emblem on the tail. So we climb through the clouds. Then followed Silencer in the dive into the furball. Pairs are as followed. I am the wingman of Silencer. Salty is wingman of Oz. You see, Silencer already kills one in the first path. I only shoot a dead plane. And we zoom up again. Here's Oz watching the dead 109, and you see Salty is sticking to the tail of Oz. So we simply zoomed one time through that furball. In the clouds, I lost sight of Silencer. I dove back into the furball. Oz and Salty are following me. Silencer is somewhere above us. Here is Oz. You see, I go up, Oz follows me, we loop around, so we basically stay above the furball. I dive back on the 109. He starts a brake turn. I just do one lazy gun pass and zoom out, shallow angle first, then I steepen up my climb, and when I look back, I notice, nobody is following me. Turned out Oz and Salty stayed with that 109, and as a result, I'm alone and have the 109 on my 6. Luckily, he has a lower energy state. He won't be able to follow me in the dive back to the battlefield. So I don't have to worry. Here you see Oz following me, and then he decides to stay with the 109. That's absolutely fine. If you're flying with 4 men, you always divide the swarm into 2 segments, 2 wing pairs, and in combat, usually the swarm breaks up very fast and turns into 2 pairs. These pairs shouldn't get separated. So, as you see, I failed after the first pass, losing my wing leader. That's not much a problem if you know each other and know the pilot is good, but well, you should avoid such situation. So here we see Oz, Salty, and another guy killing that poor 109. Yeah, Spitfire I was. Silencer also dives into the 109. Wasn't necessary. I should have stayed above Salty and Oz and just covered them. Okay. After the 109, Salty got attacked by a Focke Wulf, but turns the table extremely fast. In the first loop, he already got shots into the tail of the Focke Wulf. And in the following pass, he will again damage the tail area of the guy. And here you see it from my cockpit perspective. I see Salty is already behind the Focke Wulf, Oz is behind Salty. I zoom up, position myself above them, just providing cover. No need for me to go close to that Wulf. Also, I'm still separated from Silencer, so in my zoom up, I check my 6 o'clock, long 6 o'clock. Silencer tells me he is engaged with the 109. I turn around and dive towards him. Here is Silencer. He gets a few shots on the 109. I think that's the guy from earlier who didn't follow me back into that forest area. Silencer follows the 109. Bleeds a little bit too much speed here. I would have zoomed out. In that case, the LA-5 here wouldn't be trouble for Silencer. But this way, he could sneak up on the tail of Silencer and stay with him, because his P-47 lost too much speed. But I'm only 1.5 kilometer out, coming in to help Silencer, and there's also another friendly P-47. I get a few shots on the Lavochkin, pull up, and then I notice a second enemy. There's a 109. He's now shooting. It's a bit funny. Look, in front of him there's the P-47 chasing the LA-5. LA-5 is trying to kill Silencer. And what plane does this guy choose? Silencer. He doesn't care about his teammate. No. Result is Lavochkin and 109 sandwiched. Two P-47s behind them. Silencer still in front of them. Here you see my gun pass on the Lavochkin. I critical him now. And result of that is Lavochkin overshoots Silencer. He of course uses that chance. He's directly in front of his gun. 109 is chasing Silencer, ignoring the P-47, and I come in from 4 o'clock, sorry. And in that crossfire, the 109 dies. Silencer kills the Lavochkin. So one stupid, egoistic decision really turned the table here. For no kills and two deaths, just because of one stupid decision. While this happened, Oz got attacked by 109. First he tried to pass on the Spitfire, which was following Oz and Salty. Then he decided to go for Oz. Oz had to go defensive. Salty is pulling up, looping around to get behind the 109. Here you see him. He will get nice shots on the tail of the 109. And there's also the Spitfire. I don't know what people think. They attack three people and the first thing they do is slowing down. I mean, seriously. Okay, Oz doesn't have to worry much. He got a hit a few times, but no serious damage. And Salty and the Spitfire finishing off the 109 now. And even Oz get a few shots on the 109. So Silencer and me, we decided to stay at the point where we are. It was directly above the battlefield. We now assist the bombers attacking ground targets and give Oz and Salty the time to come to our position so we can reform as a swarm. After every engagement, take the time, regroup. Good thing also is, before starting, assign zones on the map areas which you use for regrouping. Always fight, try to fight as a group. Always try to stay as a pair. The pair shouldn't get separated. The swarm usually needs to separate into two segments in a combat. But after the engagement, regroup. Here you see Silencer and me helping the bombers, killing the ground targets. After the ground targets are dead, we form up again. And every free time is used to grab up altitude again. You see, I'm flying pretty close to Silencer. We are not in engagement. I also wanted to check damage, visual damage on his plane. He got hit a few times. But no visual damage. Silencer says planes feels okay. Okay, so we continue. We form now up with Oz and Salty. I spot the last survivor on the enemy team, lone flying Dornier 217. And we start our long shallow dive, picking up speed. And we will all attack the Dornier. You see, all four together. That I'm out. That's the signal for Silencer to take over. He stays a little bit longer than needed on the bomber. You see Salty now taking over. It's a critical situation. You should do your one pass on the bomber, call out, go in for the next pass, and here the timing is a little bit off. But, well, we never flew in that combination. It was our third sortie flying together in that group. And you will get better the more you fly together. Just one advice, if you're flying with people you don't know, it's better to stay with the classical wing leader wingman approach. So one follows the other guy and stays behind, and his duty is to clear or to keep the six of his wing leader clear. That way the new guy will learn how to do passes on the enemy, and he will be busy following you anyway. If you fly with some people more times, you will know how they react, and then you can be more flexible. Then you can change your roles anytime in combat. But as long as you don't know the other guy, it's better to stick with the classical role. One benefit also is that if you're flying in a group, your individual skill doesn't matter that much anymore. You see, we don't do any fancy maneuvers, it's pretty basic stuff. Also, the planes are not anywhere near their limits. So, you don't need to be a hot stick to be successful, if you fight with a wingman, then two average pilots will always, or not always, but in most cases, beat the higher skilled player. And tell the other guy what you are doing. So if I'm the wing leader, I will inform my wingman what I'm doing now in the attack, like, okay, I split S and dive on the bandit, or okay, I'm on my gun pass, okay, I'm going out, take over. Give short commands so the other guy know what you are doing and what you expect him to do. Communication is the key here, and it puts the game into a complete different level. Try it out. Thanks.